सर ईच एनिवर्सरी ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस इज सैक्रेड टू द कंट्री ऑन ईच एनिवर्सरी वी रिमेंबर आवर फ्रीडम फाइटर्स ऑन दिस डे वी रिकॉल द बिल्डर्स ऑफ मॉडर्न इंडिया टुडे स्टैंडिंग ऑन द सैक्रेड सॉइल ऑफ रेड फोर्ट आई रिकॉल 1857 when our first freedom fighters came to this red fort. I recall 1945 when soldiers of the Indian National Army were prosecuted here. Their only crime was that they fought for the freedom of the motherland. In 1947, at this very place, Pandit Ji hoisted the flag of independent India. Today, when we are assembled here, we remember the ideals, the principles, the values, and the dreams which inspired our freedom fighters to win freedom for the country. Today, all of us assembled here rededicate ourselves to that cause. On this 40th anniversary, we naturally think not only of the events of the last 1 year, but of the last 40 years. At the same time, we look forward to the future as well. Our elders got us freedom and entrusted us with the responsibility of safeguarding and maintaining that freedom. It is our responsibility to protect it. During these 4 decades, we faced many situations, a number of threats and also pressures. We faced conspiracies, we faced aggressions. We did not bend, we protected the unity and integrity of India with our courage, our blood, and our sacrifices. We showed to the world that India is strong. India is one and it cannot be divided. We demonstrated to the world that no one can enslave us again. We made it clear that nobody can weaken the unity of India. We made it evident that no sacrifice is too big for the security of our country, the independence of our country, and the unity of our country. No amount of labor, no amount of sacrifice is too high a price to pay for this purpose. Our soldiers, our officers give the best years of their lives to guard our frontiers and to defend us. In return, we look after them, we provide them with the best of weaponry and ammunition. We see to it that they get the best tools. We are pleased to do so. The freedom of India means the freedom of the people. The freedom of India means that we should strengthen the roots of democracy and hold impartial elections in which every citizen can participate. We conduct parliament in such a way that the voice of the people of India is listened to and which looks after and builds the future of the country. The meaning of free India is that it has an independent judiciary and rule of law. Free India means that it has a free and unfettered press. But it is not too easy to protect to democracy, especially when we find that there are people who endanger our freedom through irresponsibility and indiscipline, who show disrespect to the Constitution and its institutions through their behavior. Still, we have demonstrated that the roots of democracy in our country are deep. Our people must remain alert. It is only a government based on democracy that can function in a country like India. Our great economic achievements have been acclaimed all over the world. Gandhiji had taught us that the process of development and the task of building the country should begin with the poor people by eradicating poverty. He taught us that the moral duties should be kept in the forefront in our national life. We have taken the country forward towards these very objectives. Eradication of poverty has been given highest priority. We have used our entire energy in eradicating poverty. Indira ji gave a call for eradicating poverty. She brought about a new awakening in the country, as a result of which there was reduction in poverty. Because of her new economic program and other programs for rural development, be it NREP or JRDP or any other, there has been improvement in the lives of the poor people of the country. We see that the picture has changed during the last 40 years. 40 years ago, 2/3 of India's population was below the poverty line. Today, 2/3 of the population has come above the poverty line. This achievement is due to our anti-poverty programs. They have also shamed the hold of feudalism. Eradication of poverty has been carried forward through the Green Revolution. As a result, in just a few years' time, things have improved considerably on the frontiers. As earlier, there was drought 21 years ago. Prime Minister has to seek food grains from foreign countries. How small she felt when she has to bow down to others for food grains. It was then that she decided that never again would India appeal to foreign countries for food grains. She overlooked her technocrats and her other advisors and took steps which brought about the Green Revolution in the northwestern part of the country. Indira ji's foresight and hard work of farmers produced these desired results.